and also the miracle that you have received through obedient to your Father in Jesus Christ. And now, truly, yes. It's so sad when the doctor tells you that you're gonna, they're gonna cut your leg off, and you hear a little voice, still small voice, speaking to you that now your leg is not going anywhere. It's gonna stay with you. So, you know, that's the God we serve. That's why we're out here, to encourage you, brothers and sisters, that God is mighty and He will bless you, like our brother John here, and brother John been out. Been in the hospital for a while. We miss him, and our prayers was with him, and God helped him in the situation that he was in. So brothers and sisters, that is God's working miracle. That's who He is. He loves to heal and also to bless His chosen, like one of you, like you walking out here today in Parramatta. God loves you so much, and He wants to bless you and to do something mightily and powerful that you can share to your neighbors, to your friends, to your family, what the good Lord has done in your life, what He has done in your life. So, you know, my message today is sort of like John's one, what he shared about his testimony, and I'd like to share to you what Jesus' words that is so powerful when Jesus speaks something that He needed. When Jesus speaks something that He needed, that thing's gonna come to Him. Like what John shared to us, the word that God speak to him, your leg is gonna stay on where he was. Don't listen to the doctor what they said. Yes, the doctors are good. Like guys, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, doctors are good. You know, they are also a servant of God to look after our physical bodies. But there is a God who is mightier than them. God who gave them the wisdom to look after our body. So they are also a servant of God. At the moment, we are also a servant of God, helping you, preaching you the gospel, telling you that Jesus loves you, and telling, sharing you the message, what God has given to us to bring to you, and warn you what's happening right now at this time in the world and also in Australia. Back to my message. You know, there's a story in the Bible, not really a story, it's an event that has happened at the time of Jesus when he was on earth. So at this point of time, Jesus wanted to go to Jerusalem, but he said to his disciples, go into the village. As you go into the village, you will find a donkey, and with a baby donkey with her. Untie the donkey and bring the donkey to me. But this is the point I want to get to you, where our brothers and sisters is. Jesus said to the disciples, when the people there ask you, what are you doing? What are you doing with the donkey? Tell them that Jesus needed it. You know, listen to the message. Tell them that Jesus needed it. You know, in John's case, he needs his leg to walk around. But the doctor wants to cut it off. You know, brothers and sisters, Jesus needs you. Jesus, he needs you. Why? Because he loves you so much, and you are his children. You know, the point I'm trying to make is about the donkey. Jesus needs the donkey. And he asked the disciples to go and untie the donkey and bring the donkey to him. And if they ask what you are doing with the donkey, tell them Jesus needs the donkey. You know, I just want to make it clear. I just want to make my message short and easy to understand. We are all walking on this earth. Whether you are Christian, you are not a Christian, whether you are Muslim or you are Hindus, Buddhists, whatever. In some point in our life, we are bound in our heart. We have hurt in our heart. there's something in our life that is not right. You know, most of all, we are walking in our sins. That is the ultimate price that Jesus came for us to pay on the cross for our sins. You know, only Jesus Christ can untie us from our sin, from the bondage that we are in. You know, I don't know what kind of knot that was tied on that donkey, but because Jesus commanded to do it, and they do it easily. If Jesus needed it, and mankind doesn't want, we didn't see it, but because Jesus ordered it, Jesus ordered it to bring the donkey to him, so it was made easy for the disciples to undo what he has to do. So brothers and sisters, that's my encouragement to you, that, you know, Jesus needed of you. We are all tied in our sins, in our life. It's only take the blood of Jesus to loose us from whatever that we are bound with. Only in the name of Jesus Christ will loose us from that sin that we are in. So brothers and sisters, my encouragement to you is, if you are bound with your sin, only Jesus Christ can undo you from your sin. If you are walking in your sin, only the blood of Jesus will wash you. So that's my encouragement to you. If you are walking around with your sin, come to Jesus Christ, and he will undo that sin from you. Then you can walk happily, healthy, ever after. So that's my message to you, that Jesus loves you. He wants to undo the sin that you are carrying upon your shoulders, that weighing you down. The sin is weighing us down, but only through Jesus Christ that sin can be removed, and you can be restored into the kingdom that God has prepared for you. So come to Jesus Christ. His arm is wide open to you, brothers and sisters. Just say yes to Jesus. We are out here. You know, we are just there. Come on, come and make us work hard to pray for you. We are standing here waiting for you to come and say, I want to accept Jesus Christ into my heart. Come, pray for me. I want to pray for the sickness. I want to be healed. Jesus is the great doctor. So may God bless you all, brothers and sisters. Have a good evening in Jesus' name. Amen.